Yeah, what's
What's up?
you sound a little extra excited this morning.
I got some great stuff planned.
Yeah,
It's always exciting when you don't have to, when you can just sit and watch someone else work out.
bet.
It's always a great feeling.
It's also good to be able to just do the workout, and
That is true.
you don't have to do the other stuff. So yeah, either way. But I ain't never scared though. I'm ready. Good
Oh, I know you ain't scared. There's no reason to be scared.
morning.
Good morning, everyone. All right, well, let's dive into it. We're going to start with the warm up, okay, as we always do. Today is full body, guys, so it's going to get real interesting. We're going to start with Superman. It's probably one of my favorite warm up moves. So I'm going to put a timer on. We're going to hit Superman for 40 seconds on my
So,
count.
okay.
Are we ready?
Am I just holding it or am I doing reps or?
You're going up and down. You're
Okay.
doing reps. Okay.
All right.
And three, two, one, and go. Yes, this is definitely one of my go-to warm-up moves. Great for that lower back. Remember, you want to keep everything neutral, so don't look up. You see how Coach Obasi is looking down at the ground. There's no need to strain your neck by trying to look up.
Ain't nothing to see out there.
We got 10 seconds left. And five, four, three, two, and one. All right, good. We're going to come up on your hands and knees. We're going to hit cat camels for all of you yogis out there. You know, he thinks he's a yogi, so I figured I'd throw this in. And three, two, one, and go. Cat camels up and down. Again, we're hitting this for 40 seconds. Good. Try to round that back. Get it as high as you can. And then come back down. Again, same rules apply with that neck. Look down, do not look up. Got about 15 seconds to go, guys. Remember, this is not a move about speed. It's not a cardio move. Just warming up that body, getting that blood flowing. And five, four, three, two, and one. All right, good. We're gonna come back down. We're gonna hold a plank on our elbows. 40-second plank. All right, and three, two, one, and up. So you want to make sure that back is flat. You don't want to have your butt up in the air, right? We always tell you guys that every time we plank, no butts in the air. At the same time, you don't want those hips to be too low either, right? You don't want to do that. You'll probably feel that in your back if you're doing it, right? You want to be nice and even, not too high, but not too low. Give me 10 more seconds. Hold it and five, four, three, two, one. Good. You can stand up now. Let's warm up those arms a little bit. Okay, we're gonna hit some arm circles. So we're gonna go to the front, and then when I say switch, we're gonna hit the back. So big circles to the front and go. It's always a good idea to warm up those arms. Sometimes we warm up our core and our legs, but we kind of neglect the upper body warm up. I know I do, so I forget about that part a lot. All right, we're switching directions and to the back. Good, good. Ten more seconds. As soon as we're done that, we're going to come in and go out in five, four, three, two, one. Bring those hands into your shoulders and then out. Good. Just like that. When I say switch, we're going to go shoulders and then up to the sky. Okay. And five, four, three, two, one. Let's go shoulders and then reach for the sky. Just like that. Good, good. You might feel a little burn in your arms right now. Okay.
Not too bad.
Yeah, it shouldn't be too bad. Just a little burn. A little burn never hurt nobody.
But I'm just speaking for myself. I don't know how to, I don't know how other folks do.
Right. In three, two, one, good. All right, last warm-up move. We're gonna hit some basic squats, no weights, just body weight. All right, we're gonna squat for 40 seconds and then we're gonna move into the workout. And go. Good, so make sure when you squat, you wanna have those feet about hip width apart. Never squat from your knees, okay? Push that butt back and down. You wanna try to go as deep as, you know, about as deep as your knees, to the point where you're like almost parallel to the floor. 10 seconds left. And five, four, three, two, one, and good. Awesome, can you hear my music? Are you hearing? Okay, I wanna make sure you hear it. Okay.
Yeah, I can hear it, it's good.
All right, great. So like I said, we're hitting full body today. So our first circuit, we're going to focus on some push movements. So that just means we're going to focus a lot on shoulders, quads, triceps, chest. All right? So we're going to grab our dumbbells. We're going to hit squats first. We're going to hit squats with a press, okay? So I'm going to demonstrate right quick. I want you guys to hold your dumbbells by your shoulders. You're gonna do two bounces at the bottom. One, two, press as you come up, okay? So don't wait until you stand up to press. One, two, as you come up, press. We're hitting 15 reps. Ready, coach?
Hey, I was born ready, man. Come on.
And go. One, two, and press. Good. So we're bouncing for two, pressing for one. It's a fluid movement. This is five. Seven, good. Eight. Nine. This is 10. Don't forget your breathing, guys. I usually inhale on the easy part and I exhale on the part that's a little bit harder, so that works for you, great. Give me two more. And last one, perfect.
Yeah.
All right, now you're going to come down to the ground. You're gonna lay on your back, keeping those dumbbells. We're gonna work our chest. So we're gonna hit some chest presses on the ground, okay? So you're laying flat on your back. You're going to hit 15 chest presses with your dumbbells. So if you have something, you know, you have different types of weights, use something that's a little bit of a challenge to get to 15 with. All right?
Well, and these are not challenging, coach, but I'll make it work.
Use what you got. It's okay. Use what you got. And go. 15. One. Two. Mm-hmm. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven, mm-hmm. Eight, nine, 10, give me five more. Five, four, three, two, and one. Perfect. All right, let's come back up. We're gonna hit some more leg and upper body at the same time. I like to, when I do full body, I like to do moves where I work more than one muscle group at a time. So this time we're gonna hit alternate lunges with the lateral raise. All right, so that means you wanna come here, you're gonna lunge while you're in that position, lateral raise, and then come back up. And then the same thing on the other side. Lunge, lateral raise. We're doing 12 total, okay? All right, on my count, in 3, 2, 1, and go. Double lunge. Okay, and lateral raise. If you want to do a reverse lunge, that's fine. If you want to hit a forward lunge, that's fine too. Whatever type of lunge works for you. 4.
You know, with the knee issue, it's just more comfortable going back for me.
Yeah, I usually prefer reverse lunges over forward lunges. They're just a little bit more comfortable. All right, this is 9. 10, give me 2 more. 11, and last one, 12. Perfect. All right, we're going to give those dumbbells a break, but I want you to use either a couch, either a chair. We'll get tricep dips. So use what you got.
Okay.
Most people, I usually use my couch. If you don't want to use your couch, you've got to grab a chair from the living room or something. All right.
You didn't give me no heads up on them dips, but okay. It's all good.
But then my phone just told me the text didn't go through, so I'm sorry.
I'm good. Hey, I'm adaptable, man. I'm good. Let's go.
All right, we're going to hit 20 tricep dips. All right, so legs out, and let's go. Make sure those elbows, as you see, coach is making sure his elbows go back. Your elbows aren't going out. They're going back. That's 5, 6. 7. These are a little bit challenging for most people, especially if you don't have upper body strength, but you know, you do what you can, you work your way up. This is 12, 13, 14, 15, give me 5 more, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Perfect. All right, those are the 4 moves of the first circuit. So get some water if you need it.
Hey, I got some water today.
Yeah, get some water, and then we're going to take it from the top. So like I said, this first circuit is really focusing on push movements. So your push movements, your upper body push movements focus on your shoulders, your chest, and your triceps.
Right.
And then lower body push movements tend to focus on your quads. Mainly your quads. So things like squats, step-ups, lunges, things like that. If I'm doing a full body day, I usually like to try to like separate it by push and pull. There are different ways to do it, but that's just how I like to do it.
It's a good way to design your workout, you know, break your days down into push days and pull days. So
yeah,
there are different ways to structure a workout, but that's as good as any. A lot of people like doing push-pull.
Yeah, when I program workouts with my clients, we do push days and pull days. All right.
Let's go.
Let's hit it from the top. The bounces with the press.
Okay.
All right, guys, grab those dumbbells again. Remember, we're hitting 2 bounces into a press for 15 reps. And let's go. So 1, 2, and up. 1.
Don't count.
Oh, is it a delay?
Yeah, a little bit.
Oh, sorry. I'm sorry, guys. I don't want to throw y'all off.
I'm fine.
It actually takes effort. I'm so used to counting that it takes effort for me not to count. Like right now, I'm consciously telling myself not to count.
That's 10. Guys,
you're almost there. Quads burning in a little bit. Probably feeling it in your shoulders, but that's okay. Push through.
14. One more. Okay, good.
Perfect. All right. Next move, we're coming right down to the ground. We're hitting the dumbbell presses, dumbbell chest presses on the floor. Remember, we're hitting 15. Actually, we did 15 for the first round. Let's step it up a little bit this round. Let's do 20. Let's add 5 more. Okay? So we're going to hit 20 reps this time. All right. Laying on flat on your back. Grab your dumbbells. And let's go. Push up. Now, notice how your dumbbell should be aligned with your chest, okay? They're not like all the way back by your neck or all the way in front of you by your stomach. You want to make sure when you bring them out to the sides, they still are aligned with your chest. That's why it's called a chest press. Okay. You guys should be about halfway now. Don't forget your breathing. On this one, I would probably inhale on the lower and exhale on the push.
18. Good. Okay.
Perfect. Perfect. I like it. Keep it moving. Keep it moving. All right. We got our lunges with the lateral raise. 12 total. Let's bang it out and go. Again, if you have, you know, a few knee issues like we do, it might be more comfortable for you to step that foot back and hit that reverse lunge. That's totally fine. Some people prefer forward lunges. If you want to lunge forward, that's fine too. But you do want to focus on getting that knee down. You should be at about maybe like a 90 degree angle when you come down.
One more. Yeah.
Awesome. Get rid of those dumbbells. You know, we got chest. Oh, nope. Tricep dips. I almost said the wrong thing. Tricep dips. We're hitting 20. All right. Let's hit it. And go. Good, good, guys. At home, make sure you pay attention to what your elbows are doing. Be aware of the movement, okay? Don't just do anything to get through it. You want to make sure that your form is good, too. Keep that body close to that chair. There shouldn't be a huge gap between the chair or the couch and your back, okay? Keep it close, elbows going back. Yeah! All right. That was circuit one. We have circuit two coming up. So circuit one, our emphasis was push. Circuit two, we're going to do pull movements. Pull movements tend to work your biceps, your back, your hamstrings, your glutes. Okay, so let's get a quick sit if you need it. And we're going to move on to pull. All right, your first move of this circuit, you're going to hit a deadlift into a bent over row. All right, we're going to hit 15 reps. So you grab your dumbbells. I want you to start here. You bend over into that deadlift. Pull. Come back up. It's one. Okay? Pull.
Got it.
All right. Again, like I said, working those hamstrings with the deadlift, with the bent over row, we're working our back.
Hey.
All right. We are going to hit 15.
Alexa, adjust my phone.
Right, if only. Instagram with this weird layout, this weird live thing.
Yeah, well, when you have two people, definitely.
Yeah. All right.
I'm ready.
And go. Let's hit 15. Pull up. Yep. And then stand back up. So remember, guys, it's a deadlift. A deadlift is not the same thing as a squat, okay? Deadlift is a hip hinge movement. So you push your hips back like Coach O is doing. All right. Squat, your body comes down. Deadlift, your butt comes back, okay? That's the easy way to remember if you ever get confused. Yeah, Coach L over there killing it. Making it look easy.
I do this for a living.
Yeah. Remember, with 15 guys, you should be almost done.
I think that's 13.
Okay.
I ain't new to this, man. Come on.
True to this. Great, great, great. All right, second move, we have Zottman curls.
What kind of curl?
What'd you say?
What are we doing?
Zottman curls. All right, Zottman curls, like two curls in one. So you do a regular curl, Zottman, you split your wrist, and then you go back down. Okay, so up, flip your wrist into a reverse curl, and back down, okay?
So here, switch, there. Yep.
Zottman curls, you're hitting 12, okay?
I think we could do 15 of those.
Well, let's hit 15 then.
Let's not go too easy on them.
All right, I'm down with that. 15 Zottman curls coming up and go. So you're yep and down. You just flick rotating your wrist at the top. It's 3. And make sure you have a weight that I mean, it's always good to challenge yourself, but at the same time, you never want to compromise your form. So I would probably use like 8s or 10s on this. Nothing too crazy. You probably don't want to use your 15s for this unless you're like...
I need some 15s.
You need some 15s? I mean, unless you're like an advanced, you know, if you're a beginner, then you definitely ain't using 15s. But
I have no idea. I think that's about... This should be it right here.
Okay.
I lost count.
I'll take it. All right. Next, we're going to work those hamstrings again. So we are going to lay on the floor on our backs. You can use either use the chair that you use for your tricep dips. Use your couch if you want. We're going to hit glute bridges, but we're going to elevate our feet. So you want to put your heels up on either the chair or the couch, and you're going to hit elevated foot glute bridges. Okay? So it looks like Coach O is going to use a chair. Is that a chair? I can't see it, but I'm going to assume it's a chair. Can you either move back so they can see like what you're doing with your feet? Like, can you pull the chair back into the frame? Okay, there we go. So lay on your back, put your feet up, okay? We're going to hit 20. And go. Yeah, this really forces those hamstrings to work a little bit harder. This is one of my favorite glute bridge variations. Elevated foot glute bridge. Good, good. Make sure you squeeze those glutes at the top. That should be about halfway, guys. Remember, we're hitting 20. Keep it moving. You might feel that burn just a little bit. It's a good move, though.
Yeah.
Nice. Love that move right there.
So on those, it really helps if you dig your heels into the chair or the couch.
Oh, yeah. Whatever you're using, definitely dig your heels down into it. It'll help you get that body up.
Well, yeah, I felt it in my hamstrings a little bit more when I did that.
Mm-hmm. All right, we're coming up. And now we're going to hit hammer curls with a twist, okay? So, hammer curls with a twist, meaning, I'm sorry, I had to look at my list. All right, so one arm is going to hit hammer curls. The other arm, you're going to hold it straight out. Okay, so we're really working that shoulder and the biceps at the same time. All right, we're hitting 15 on each side. So cool. Don't let that, some people, my clients tend to start here, and then by the time, yeah, that arm tends to come down. Keep that arm up. And 3, 2, 1, let's go. We're hitting 15 on each side.
Yeah, these are challenging right here.
Oh, yeah. And you don't need a crazy weight either. You'll feel it.
It's not the curl. It's the arm that's hanging out.
Exactly. What I tend to do is if I'm in the gym, I think you have like 2 more. If I'm in the gym, I'll use a lighter weight on the hold and then like a heavier weight on the curl.
Oh, okay.
But yeah, I never go too crazy with that. The weight that with the arm out, because That'll tear you up real quick.
It's good, though. I like that isometric hold, man.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of isometric holds. Almost there, guys. Keep moving. You should have alternated sides.
Yeah.
Okay. We're talking, but you guys don't forget to alternate sides.
I think they saw me switch up.
All right, good. Dumbbells down. Get a quick sit. Those were our four moves from the second circuit, okay? So just to review, we did the deadlifts with the bent over rows, working the hand knees in the back, the Zottman curls, working those biceps, elevated foot glute bridge, working those hammies and that booty, and then the hammer curls with the arm out. Start from the top.
Let's go.
All right. And go. Deadlift with the bent over row. Let's hit it. Good, guys. So make sure you're pulling those arms so that those elbows are coming straight up, like towards the ceiling. You don't want to have your elbows too far away from your body. Okay, they're not out. They're back. Make sure you're aware of your deadlift form. Make sure you're hitting deadlifts and not squats, okay? Knees can be slightly bent with the deadlift. They don't have to be, you don't want to lock your knees. Slightly bent, but it's not a squat, okay? It's a hip hinge. So put that butt back. Almost there.
Yeah.
Nice, nice, nice. All right. Good old Zottmans. Let's hit 15 Zottmans. Somebody's okay. Good over there. All right, let's hit it. And go. 15. There we go.
Oh, you got creative today.
Oh, yeah, I like a full body circuit because it allows me to, like, mix up stuff, do compound moves. I love me a good compound movement.
You went into, you dusted off the old workout stuff.
We started doing these during quarantine because I was doing bicep curls, and I'm like, all right, I need a new variation.
Right. You was all on YouTube for these.
I was on like different variations of biceps.
It's good though.
Come back down to the ground. Get that chair or use that couch. We're hitting 20 glute bridges. Feet elevated. Remember, like Coach O said, push both heels into the chair. Okay, so really feel it in your hands. And go. Like I said, this is definitely one of my favorite forms, the glute bridges. I think my other favorite form would be single leg elevated glute bridges. Those are really challenging too. Yeah. You feel that like crazy as well. But you know, you always want to try to, you know, kind of master one variation before you move on to the next. Or sometimes, you know, it's good to just try to challenge yourself, even if you haven't completely mastered something else yet. So. I see the hammies lurking. I see them. Yeah. You should have a few more left, guys, at home. Keep pushing. Nice. Nice. Love it, love it, love it. Love to see it. All right. We got everybody's favorite, the hammer curls, holding the arm out to the side. Let's go. Hitting 15. As soon as you're done with one side, you switch sides. Good, guys. Breathe. Don't hold your breath, okay? Inhale through the nose. Push it out through your mouth. Remember, we're not letting that arm fall until we're done, okay? You start here, you stay there. You don't end here. Okay, keep that arm out. good. Looking good, Colts. Looking good. Looking great. Keep it moving.
Yeah.
Yes. Love to see it. Love to see it.
Yeah.
All right. So we did two rounds of push focus movements. We did two rounds of moves with the emphasis on pull. And the third circuit, which is how I usually, you know, last thing I usually hit my clients with is HIIT. So we are going to do HIIT, which is high intensity interval training, meaning you work hard for a certain amount of time, you rest, work hard, rest, okay? So we are going to do 30 seconds of rest, 15 seconds of rest. I have a timer. Don't worry, I'll keep track of the time. We have three different moves that we're hitting, okay? Your first move, if I can find it. Okay, your first move that you're gonna do for 30 seconds, inchworms, okay? We all know we did inchworms last week. Inchworms, you crawl out onto your hands, crawl back, jump at the top. If you can't jump, that's fine. You don't have to jump at the top, but if you can jump, then jump. Second move.
You mean a crawl out?
Yeah, inchworms, crawl out, whatever.
See,
I call them inchworms.
I don't call them inchworms.
Oh, crawl out then. All right. Your second move you're going to hit is going to be bicycle crunches. Okay, you're going to work those abs. The third move, keeping it simple, jumping jacks. Okay. Can you do jumping jacks? Is your knee okay?
Yeah, I can do jump jacks.
All right. So those are the three moves you're doing.
What was the second one?
Bicycle crunches.
Okay.
So every move, we're doing 30 seconds, 15 seconds of rest. I'm going to warn you that 15 seconds of rest is going to feel like 5 seconds because it goes by so fast. That's what my clients always say. But we're going to make it work. All right. I got my timer ready. All right. You are going to hear it. And I'll also tell you when to stop. First move, crawl out. And 3, 2, 1, and go. So people at home, I have this lovely HIIT timer. Okay. So remember, this is HIIT, high intensity, meaning you want to go as hard as you can for 30 seconds. Rest for 15. And then we'll go on to the next move, okay? This is the last 10 minutes of the workout, so make it count. One, and rest. All right, it's going to come down to the ground. Bicycle crunches, I'll tell you when to go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and bicycles. Let's go. All right. I love to do cardio and incorporate some abs into my HIIT. Now, that core might start burning, but again, that's all right. I'm going to push through. I need 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest. All right, the rest is more like an active rest where you got to move and get ready for the next move. All right, we got jumping jacks.
Oh, jumping jacks. Okay.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and let's go. Good, guys. Don't forget your breathing, okay? Halfway, I need 15 more seconds. We rest, and then we take it back from the top, the inchworms, okay? Heart rate is definitely up by now. 3, 2, 1, and rest. All right. If you need a quick sip, you better hurry up and get it. Sneak it in.
I don't need no water.
And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Inchworms, crawl outs.
You said get water. I thought we was on a break.
I said 15 seconds. So you need to get water. Hurry up, and then we're going to crawl out.
You thought I killed my ass. I'm like, wait a minute.
Three moves. Crawl out, bicycles, crunches, jumping jacks. 10 seconds. Three, two, one, and good. Coming down to the ground. Let's hit those bicycles. I'll tell you when to start. Three, two, one, let's go. Getting that elbow to the opposite knee. Keeping that core engaged. I usually always say hit for the end because you want to use most of your energy for weight. And then cardio was like a good finisher. Okay, it's going to tire you out. Three, two, one, and rest. All right, good. We're coming up. We got jumping jacks, remember? And five, four, three, two, one, and good. We currently have 6 minutes and 25 seconds left. Okay, we started at 10 minutes, so the clock is counting down. We are almost halfway there. Okay? Give me 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. Quick sip if you need it. We're going to start with those crawl outs again. All right.
You ain't got no time for no sip.
My clients are like, they grab that water bottle real quick. And let's go. Crawl out. And it's funny because every time I do this with somebody, they always swear we've been doing it for 20 minutes. And it's only 10 minutes, guys. It might feel longer. But I swear, the clock is set for 10 minutes, okay? All right, give me 10 more seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest. Yep, you know what's next by now. You know we got those bicycle crunches coming up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and let's hit it. We just hit the 5 minute mark, so we are almost there, okay? Don't give up on yourself. Keep pushing. I need 15 seconds. Keep it going, keep it going, keep it going. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and good. Jumping jacks. And the great thing about HIIT is you can do it anywhere, you know. You don't need a treadmill, you don't need to be in the gym to do this. You can literally do this type of thing, this type of cardio anywhere. No equipment. And jumping jacks. Let's go, let's go. Breathe, guys, breathe. 15 seconds. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and good. How you feeling, coach?
I'm good, man.
All right, let's hit these crawl outs.
It takes a lot to get me.
2, 1, and let's go, guys. Crawl out. Remember, add that jump at the top if you can. If you have some type of limitation, you can't jump. That's fine. Just stand up and then crawl right back out. Three, two, one, and good. We just hit the 3 minute mark. We are almost there, okay?
Come on, y'all. Let's finish up.
Finish strong. Start it strong, finish strong.
Don't let her beat you.
go. I had fun designing this workout this morning. I tell you, we're going to do a little bit of everything. We're going to push. We're going to pull. We're going to hit some hits. 15 seconds. Last 10. Two, one, and stop.
You ain't gonna beat us, coach.
All right, now that's all I like to hear.
We ain't scared.
5, 4, 1, and jumping jack.
That's all you got, coach. That's all you got.
He won. He won.
Bring it, coach, bring it. Come on, man.
I need 10 more seconds. Keep it resting. And rest. All right, we got our last round. So we're hitting each move one more time, and we're done. We're at the 1 minute, 23 second mark, so that'll take us down to 0 seconds. 3, 2, 1, come on, crawl out. Jump at the top. As fast as you can. Remember, you do not want to take your time and hit. It's called high intensity training for a reason, okay? You want to exert yourself before you rest. Give me 10 seconds. Three, two, one, good. Come on down to the ground. This is it.
Come on, y'all. Bicycle. Let's finish this thing off.
And three, two, one, let's go. Good, guys. Good. Come on. 15 seconds. Last 10. Push through. Push through. Fight through that burn. 3, 2, 1, and done. Oh, actually, I lied. That was the last part. That took us to 0 seconds.
Huh?
That was it. I thought we had to do one more, but that took us to zero. That was 10 minutes right there.
Oh, look at them jumping jacks.
All right. You can do it. Sure. And 3, 2, 1, and go.
We might as well finish the whole circuit.
All right. Jumping jacks.
I had my mind on finishing it.
15 seconds. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and done. We are done. How do you feel? Clap it up for the folks at home, for Coach O, to me for designing a good workout.
That was a good one.
Yeah, I liked it.
I'm about to sit down in this chair, though.
As you should. You deserve it.
Man, that was good work. How y'all feeling out there?
Some little hands, a little thumbs up, a little something. Let us know how you feel.
So let me tell y'all something. So normally, when we do these sessions, we both know what the workout is. I mean, obviously, if we're working out at the same time, we know. But sometimes, even in the past, you know, both of us would still know the workout, even if one of us was just doing, you know, the actual work. But today, I was in the dark just like everybody else. I had no idea. So that was good, though. That's good work. I needed that.
Good. You know? Glad you enjoyed it.
Like, go
on it.
like Goldilocks said, it wasn't too hot, it wasn't too cold. it was just right.
Somebody said, I feel like my life was snatched. Good.
I don't know if that's a good thing, but okay.
That means she worked hard. She felt like her life was snatched. Zerged herself a little bit there.
Hey man, look. I know in New Jersey it's getting cold, I'm sure. Temperature starting to dip here too, man. So a lot of folks gonna be inside working out over the next few months. So, you know, just make Sunday your once a week stop, you know, to work out with us and bring two or three friends with you. You know, don't just bring one, bring two or three, four or five people with you.
Yeah. You know, so, or if you're at home, you know, you don't want to, you know, well, tell your friends, obviously, but tell the people in your household, too. Get your spouse involved, your kids, you know. Make it a family affair. Every Sunday, you guys know what you have to look forward to. So start the week off the right way.
Absolutely. So we'll probably keep this format. I mean, I think it works pretty well. So we'll be just kind of alternate training each other. So I think that's a good flow. So next week, you know what time it is.
I will be ready. I will.
Yeah, I feel good, man. I ate a light breakfast, as everyone should have, about an hour and a half before we trained. But, it's good to be able to work out and not have to think about, you know, anything.
Yes, you know? Yeah.
It's good to have somebody just steering you through the workout, pushing you through.
Right.
You know, because you're working out by yourself, I don't care who you are, you never push really the way that you should push.
Mm-hmm.
Like we all just kind of, you know, you might have five more reps in you, but you told yourself you was only going to do 15, so that's all you do.
Yeah, you know? Yeah. I have my best workout. I mean, I have some good workouts by myself, but I have my best workouts when I work out with someone else. Like David, when David trains me, it's always different from when I train myself, just because, like you said, he pushes me to do more than I would have thought to do on my own.
Right.
So, because you kind of limit yourself and say, oh, I can only do this many. I can only go this heavy. But when you have someone else there, it definitely makes a difference. So, great job, guys. Drink your water. Yes. Eat a meal if you haven't already. Something with some protein, some healthy carbs. Okay. My go-to is oatmeal and egg whites. With a little avocado on the side. So, you know, whatever you like to eat, just make sure it's something healthy. And then we have Coach Talk coming up this Wednesday. So remember, we made it bi-weekly. So we didn't do this past Wednesday, but we will be live this Wednesday at 8 p.m. Eastern Time, 7 p.m. Central.
And we're going to be talking about keto, the pros and cons of
keto.
The infamous, I don't know if infamous is the right word, but the pros and cons of adopting a keto way of life or a keto diet. So
yeah.
we're gonna get on in there and peel the onion back a little bit. And for those of you who are thinking about keto or you're just curious about what keto is all about, you know, make sure you tune in Wednesday. You know, we're not passing judgment. We're just providing information. So make sure you tune in for that. And if you want to repeat this workout sometime during the week, of course, I'm going to save it on my IGTV. You can find all the past workouts there. So, you know, we're just taking the guesswork out of it for you. All you got to do is pull that video up and, you know, you got you 35 to 40 minutes of hell. Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. We have so many workout videos on there at this point that, yeah, you got to definitely go back and revisit them. You don't need to switch up your workouts every week. Like, if you use the videos that we have, you use them for a few months, just keep doing them, same videos over and over, increasing your weight as you go. Maybe you do upper body one day, lower body one day, full body, and then core and cardio. Just keep doing those week after week, increasing your weight each week. You'll be fine, okay? We literally take the guesswork out of it for you. So you just got to stay consistent. That's all.
And we always do these things with minimal equipment, you know, but, you know, make sure you have at least a couple of sets of dumbbells. If you have, let me grab mine real quick. If you have, me and Ebony were talking about resistance bands. So this is a resistance band. That stuff that y'all women put around your hips to do booty work.
That's a booty band, I guess.
Those are booty bands. But I'm not saying that's cool if you want to have those, but make sure you have, you can get these from Five Below, Walmart, a whole bunch of different places. So they have different levels of resistance. This one's probably heavy, but they got medium and light. And I would say maybe get one of you know, get all three, because you can do all kinds of stuff. You can do full body stuff with resistance bands. You can do, you can squat with some resistance with these. You can do curls. You can do tricep work. I was doing seated rows with these yesterday. You just wrap it around something heavy that won't move. And I sat on the floor and I just did seated rows.
Yeah.
I mean, you can just do a whole range of things. So, you know, unfortunately, as the gym's probably move in that direction of closing back down at some point, just make sure you have what you need at home. You don't got to have a lot of stuff, but, you know, again, watching our videos, tuning in to what we do, and, you know, you'll be able to get a good workout. See, I'm sweating, so. If I'm sweating, that means Coach did a good job. So you don't need a gym. No excuses. You just show up here Sunday mornings.
Every Sunday.
Every Sunday. All right, Coach. So that's all I got, man. I got to go take a shower.
Yeah, I'm about to go eat me some breakfast because I didn't eat anything this morning yet. So my stomach is barking. So I'm going to go do that.
I had Cheerios, but I'm hungry again.
Yeah, that ain't going to last you too long.
You're welcome. Who is that? Okay. Thank you. I can't read anything, y'all. I don't have my glasses, but I do see the thank you. But
No problem, guys.
Thanks for tuning in. We'll see y'all for Coach Talk on Wednesday and see you right back here next Sunday. You guys have a good weekend. Please be safe. Prepare for the week. Drink a lot of water, food prep. Do all that stuff. Set yourself up for success.
Amen.
Deuces.
See you guys on Wednesday.
Mwah.
Peace.